Hello! Welcome back to my channel. If you're watching me for the first time, my name is Jara. I study evidence-based medicine at the University of Oxford and work as a doctor in England. So let's start today's topic. We all have to learn new things in life, and it's useful to have a framework that helps us learn effectively and quickly. Over the years, I have tried and tested many different methods to find out what works for me. And I think I have found a combination of tools and techniques that help me learn complex ideas in a short amount of time and gain mastery over them. I'm making this video to share that combination in case it helps someone. I would also like to know how you approach learning, especially complex ideas, and any cool stuff you've found that works wonders. The method I follow has one overarching strategy and three steps. Here are the timestamps that show when I discuss which one. I'll be discussing quite a few ideas in the video. I will show all action points on the screen, like you can see now, so that you can relax while watching the video and still don't miss out on any important stuff. Great, now let's dive in. The one overarching strategy I follow is creating space for diffuse mode of thinking. What do I mean by that? Let me give you some examples. One of my friends at Oxford used to say he works best under pressure. He would defer working on his assignments until it is very close to the deadline. One time, when he turned in his paper, his tutor gave him a feedback, which he says changed his life. The feedback read like this. It seems from your work that you like to work under pressure. While this method is very popular among students, it's not suitable for high quality work. To produce a high quality work, you need to give yourself some time for reflection after you write the paper. It is during those periods of reflection that you improve your arguments. After this feedback, my friend modified his style and used to start working as early as possible to allow time for reflection. This has significantly increased his marks on assignments. We're always looking for highly productive sessions where we focus on a topic and try to understand it. This is called focused mode of thinking. When we are off the focused mode and trying to relax, our minds shift to another mode of thinking, we call it diffuse mode. While in this diffuse mode, our minds subconsciously try to work on the problem and form connections for us. Let me share another quick example from my life that I think you'd be able to relate to. Very often, I would discuss a topic with my classmates, and then when I'm in the shower, I think of a really good example that would explain my reasoning much better. Sometimes this happens when I'm doing the dishes, going for a walk, trying to sleep, you get the idea. Our best thoughts often come when we are calm and relaxed and not thinking about the issue actively. I think I have made my case for the strategy, so how do I integrate it in my learning? I try to start learning the subject as early as possible. When I hit a bump after a few hours of focused work, meaning I can no longer focus to make progress and it seems like I've taken too much information in, I take a break from the work to go for a walk, take a nap, or do other things so that my brain can subconsciously form connections. Okay, sleep needs a special mention here. I'm not kidding when I say this one recent study indeed showed that sleep between learning sessions reduces the amount of practice needed by half and ensured much better long-term retention. The study concludes that sleeping after learning is definitely a good strategy, but sleeping between two learning sessions is a better strategy. This is perfect for me because I love sleep and I can fall asleep anytime, anywhere. One bonus tip, because sleep has such a positive impact on learning, instead of starting a topic tomorrow morning, I make it a point to squeeze in some hours of learning before I go to sleep tonight so that my brain can start processing it in the background. I'll put some research on sleep in the description box below. Feel free to explore if you want to learn more. Now that we are done with the strategy, let's talk about the three steps. Number one is plugging the gaps. The first thing I do while approaching any topic is to identify if I have any gaps in the foundational knowledge. For example, if I'm trying to learn about human metabolism, but do not have a sound understanding of how different organs in the body function, I'll surely find the topic very challenging. In the same vein, someone who did not learn the basics of math would find the subject more and more dreadful as they progress. It's a simple idea, but one that we often forget. I have seen many leaving the hopes of understanding a subject and start memorizing because they do not have the foundational knowledge. Okay, so that's step one. Once I finish foundational work, I come to the second step, which is developing understanding with learning aids. Here are some of my favorite learning aids. First, drawing a timeline. When I'm reading something that has dates, months, years attached to it, I draw a timeline. They help me understand the chronology of events as well as remember it. The timeline is not relevant only for historical events. If I'm trying to understand arguments which took place across multiple platforms, for example, books, research papers, guidelines, television or radio interviews, I put a date of when each of them were published. It helps me put everything in context and remember things easily. Second, a step-by-step chart. Different authors might break down the same process differently. Some might say it's a two-step process, while others would say it's a six-step process. What I try to do is draw a process of my own. Doing this work myself forces me to compare the work by different scholars and learn it really well. Needless to say, it also helps me remember. The same goes for tables, hierarchical charts, etc. 3. Drawing the idea. This is especially useful when I'm studying different diseases, human biology, etc. There are many other learning aids. This video would be too long if I get into the details. The idea, in short, is to utilize learning aids to break down complex ideas. Once I feel that I have gotten a grasp of the subject, I turn to the last or third step, testing my understanding. What I do at this stage is try to explain the topic as simply as possible. I borrowed this from the Feynman technique. What's the benefit and how do I do it? First, the benefit. When I try to explain the topic, I really have to put all the ideas together. When I put the ideas together and try to explain, I get to see the gaps in my learning. New questions come up and I often do a bit more research to get more clarity. How do I do it? If I can get hold of my sister, I usually dish out my newfound wisdom on her. She's a very keen listener and often asks pertinent questions, which ultimately helps me find the gaps in my learning. If I do not have my sister available or if she isn't interested in my newfound wisdom, I sometimes make a selfie video and then watch it. While watching, I start questioning myself. Asking questions is the key. If I do not have anyone to explain it to or do not feel like making a selfie video, I resort to the third option. This, I think, is the best way to do it, but unfortunately, this is also the one where it takes the most amount of time. It's just that I take the pen and paper and write out the idea. Whichever of the three mediums I use, I keep the following in mind. I try to explain the ideas in such simple terms that anyone from any other discipline can understand the topic. In my case, since I study medicine, I try to explain in a way so that people who are not from medicine are able to understand it. Why? Because otherwise, I will end up using jargons that might mask my lack of understanding. By forcing myself to avoid any jargons and technical terms, I can uncover any hidden weaknesses in my understanding. This ultimately helps achieve mastery on that topic. If you feel that you do not have the time to write out the whole idea on a piece of paper, identify the areas where you're shaky and write down that bit. This is not recommended, but I think it's better than not doing it at all. Once I learn something by applying these three steps, I find it hard to forget the topic. One caveat, I explain the techniques in three steps. However, it's not a rigid step-by-step process. For example, you can use learning aids to better understand your foundational knowledge. Well, I hope this video was useful for you. I did not discuss memorization techniques in this video. If that's something you would be interested in, let me know in the comment section below. See you soon!